2020 Gilbert Classical Academy Fall Virtual Choir Concert. Kangoma, the song that you just heard, featured all of the singers in all five of our choirs. It's a traditional Brazilian song sung in Portuguese, celebrating the freedom from slavery with the playing of drums, singing, and dancing. Hopefully, the music that you will hear tonight will inspire you to sing and dance. For the past few weeks, some of the choir students have been meeting here in the GCA choir room. But the performances that you hear tonight were all recorded remotely, then edited together into a virtual choir performance. There are over 300 video submissions in the concert tonight. Each singer put in hours of practice and tackled some technological challenges to make amazing music together. Our first choir that you will hear tonight is Belchantism. Ben Chantezud, that's French for beautiful singers. Belle Chanteuse is a choir for 7th and 8th grade girls. Some of these young ladies are brand new to choir, but you wouldn't know that by their talented voices. They'll be performing a song called The Tide Rises, The Tide Falls, with beautiful poetic imagery by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, set to music by the composer Victor C. Johnson. This song conjures images of nature and the lonesome traveler. Let's hear from a few of those choir members about this beautiful song.
The tide rises, the tide falls reminds me of how happy I am to be in this big GCA choir.
My family goes to the beach every year in October, and this song reminds me of that trip we take. It's a lot of fun.
And what it means to me is that there'll always be the next day to fix any mistakes that you made in the previous day or anything that you're just not happy about. And there'll always be that extra day that's always going to happen that you can fix things and make everything better.
Please enjoy Belle Chanteuse performing The Tide Rises, The Tide Falls by Victor C. Johnson.
Love is sea, sand, toil, love.
GCA. Laconis is a choir for 7th, 8th, and 9th grade boys. Their name comes from the Latin word for Spartans. These guys are strong, loud, and full of energy, but they're performing a song tonight that also showcases their ability to sing beautifully and nuanced. The Dawn's Awake is a poem by Otto Leland Bohannon and set to music by Laura Farnell. It artistically describes the arrival of the morning sun. Here are a few of the boys to tell you about the song.
To me, the song Dawn's Awake connects the two ideas of hope and ambition together by explaining that it's a new day and your thousands of dreams can become a reality.
I think the song, The Dawn's Awake, is trying to send or portray the message of people should focus on the good, not on the negative. Like how it says, light has come, light has overcome the darkness of sadness or despair. It's just trying to send out a positive message of focus on the good in the world.
To me, The Dawn's Awake means that you can let go of all your fears and worries and be happy because you just have to know that the sun is rising and it's a new day. And you're going to try your best at whatever you do. And you're going to have a fresh start.
Please enjoy Laconis performing The Dawn's Awake by Laura Farnell.
Whispers of pent up harmonies mingled with the scent of trees, a hymn of eternal spring, voices of new awakening. Thank you.
Cantate, our choir for 9th and 10th grade girls. These young ladies are amazing. They got the opportunity to collaborate with Mrs. Jocelyn, our orchestra director, who plays violin on this piece. And So I Sing is an inspiring poem by James Weldon Johnson that encourages us to overcome adversity through music. Composer Christy Jones set this poem to music perfectly, taking us on a journey from the somber, minor tonalities of the opening violin solo to the soaring finale. Let's hear what the ladies have to say about this song.
In the song, And So I Sing, I think that the composer was trying to convey how beautiful and healing music can be to someone, especially someone who's experiencing some hardships or obstacles in their life. I really think that the composer is trying to show how music can really let a person know that they're going to be okay and that they can face whatever lies ahead.
The lyricist tried to put forth a very sincere message that singing really does have the ability to bring a smile on one's face. It can help reduce stress and it'll just calm your mind. Like the lyrics say in the song, singing can turn a gloomy day into a bright and cheerful one. Especially for me, whenever I sing, it always brings a smile on my face.
I know that throughout all the challenges I face, I turn to music, and that's kind of in what this song represents. Like, I will still keep singing, even if all these challenges keep pushing me.
Please enjoy Cantate's performance of And So I Sing by Christy Jones.
Thank you.
inspiring. Our next choir is a real treat. The Advanced Vocal Ensemble is made up of members from our large concert choir, Chorale. But this small group performs vocal jazz. Tonight, they'll be singing a song about what it means to be a good friend, a trusted confidant, and a good listener. No matter how far apart, you can always pick up the phone and call me. Rosanna Eckert adapted this classic jazz song by Tony Hatch for Vocal Jazz Ensemble. Here's what AV has to say about Call Me.
To me, the song means that you have at least one specific person to rely on, be it a family member, a good friend, a teacher, or a guardian. I think Call Me emphasizes the love and trust between individuals to help form stronger bonds. Call Me recognizes the importance of having a safe space within yourself or someone else, especially in a time like this when everything is so uncertain.
The song is just, you know, like, hey, call me if you need me, call me. And like, I'll be here. And that's a really good message right now, because, you know, there's a lot going on and I feel like everybody's struggling with something to some extent. It doesn't really matter what it is, but, you know, just I know having that experience in the past of having someone that I can call to, or, you know, be just a text away, just a walk down the street away, to kind of help me out, you know?
There's always somebody there for you that you can call if you need a shoulder to cry on, if you need somebody to talk to, just call. Like, that's how I am with all my friends, or anyone in general. Like, if you just need someone to talk to, literally call me.
Now, let's enjoy the Advanced Vocal Ensemble with special solos by Ethan Johnson, Katarina Stender, Iman Masood, and Noah Skilly, performing Rosanna Eckert's Call Me.
That I can do.
Oh, if you call, I'll be right with you. You and I should be together.
Take the love I long to give you. I'll be
at your side forever.
Tell me, and I'll be around.
There's so much that I can do.
Ad Astra, it literally means in Latin to the stars. So it's kind of a motivator for me because it's telling me that no matter what struggles we go through, we can still overcome them no matter what. So to the stars we go. I think that's a beautiful message. And I also love the music in general as it swells. It just has an all-in-all beautiful message.
To me personally, I think it means, like, basically the literal Latin translation is, like, to the stars, you know? So meaning, like, to the stars is you're going above and beyond the expectations. You're going places that, you know, you can't physically go, but you know that you're going.
Even through hardships and even through their struggles of life, there is always the stars. And I think that this can connect with me in a way because, like the stars, I feel that a lot of people get downed by life, and I feel that this song is pretty inspirational when it tells you to reach for the stars.
Singing itself is so filled with passion and power, and a song like Ad Astra just really highlights that, and singing together as a choir after so long was such an uplifting experience.
Let the music take you to the stars as Corral performs Jacob Navarrete's Ad Astra.
Thank you.
Song Bridge Over Troubled Water, it actually means a lot to me. My older sister, who's also like just my best friend in the world, she went to Campo Verde for high school and they sang the song at graduation, and my sister was like one of the soloists in it. So basically every time I sing this song or I hear that song, like, I think of my sister and best friend singing it, and it just makes the song itself mean a lot more to me personally.
I think the song Bridge Over Troubled Water is about, as a community, getting over a hurdle that you couldn't have gotten over individually. And that definitely applies to today because we're all in the same boat. We're all trying to just do our best in the new situation that we're in. And that's really important to be binding as a community and know the importance of one another.
To me, Bridge Over Troubled Water is more or less a story about helping your friends and your friends helping you. You being their bridge over the hard times, the troubled water. And they'll be there for you. And to me, the line "Sail On Silver Girl" is not just about a girl, but like sailing on, like keep living. No matter how hard times get.
And now, our last song tonight. Enjoy Corral performing Kirby Shaw's arrangement of Bridge Over Troubled Water.
I'll be your bridge over troubled water. When you're down, I will care. Tears are in your eyes.
to Sean Ablee, our IT representative here at GCA, who got me the software that it took to put this whole thing together. It would not have been possible without Sean. And a special thanks to our PTO, who have always supported the GCA Choir Department. Check out our website, gcachoirs.com, and like us on Facebook, and stay up to date with all the events that are happening with the GCA Choirs. Thank you again for coming tonight to the GCA Choir Fall 2020 Virtual Concert. Good night.